You want to burn me?
Fishing is a dangerous activity in Uganda unless you follow the tough laws set. The army mans the waters with their fisheries protection unit, ever destroying illegal fishing gears. Thousands of local fishermen have been netted out of the waters.
Enforcement is not about only the legality of the net, but the safety of the fishers.
Aquaculture has been the alternative to reduce the pressure on wild fish. San became the pioneer of cage fish farming in Uganda 16 years ago. It all starts at the hatchery.
The broodstocks are literally kept in their breeding pond for 3 weeks, and then after that we come back and transfer them.
They grow tilapia in the clear open waters of Lake Victoria, with some of the largest cages in the region, in which fish swim far and deep against natural currents.
We feed by response. We make sure we do it as a business. We'll use less feeds to produce weight of fish, muscle of fish.
In this 12-meter diameter cage, you can get about 25 to 30 tons of fish. The feeding is intensive, and the feed is commercially produced with balanced nutrients sufficient to help the fish grow to the desired size within 8 months.
The Fisheries and Aquaculture Bill before Parliament seeks to introduce stringent policies in the subsector. The proposals include gazetting landing sites and regulating fish feeds.
We want to promote sustainability in the industry, either through wild catch practices or through aquaculture practices, because the community that is living along the lake shores will have to find alternative livelihood. If they don't have gardens and they earn their livelihood from the lake, the question is, what is that help that the government needs to put in place to make sure that they are able to continue living and they have source of income?
Fish is still expensive or less available for Ugandans as stocks continue to decline in the wild. It's why cage fish farming is being promoted as the answer to the challenges. Razia Athman, on Lake Victoria in Jinja, Uganda.